from one of the best cars on the road, we go to the one of the best cars, one of the SUVs on the road, and we're talking now to editor-in-chief at Motor Trend, Edward Lowe. How are you, Edward?
I'm good. Thanks for having me.
Thank you very much for your time again. So last week, Motor Trend announced its pick for the SUV of the year, which is a major, major award. The manufacturers really appreciate that, and the consumers too, right? So can you tell us a little bit about the reasoning behind you picking for the Forester 2014?
Yeah, we're really proud to select the 2014 Sport Utility of the Year as the Subaru Forester. As far as why we did it, the rationale is it's not a comparison test. That's what a lot of people need to understand, a lot of confusion about it. What we do is we take all of the all-new or significantly updated sport utility vehicles for the model year 2014. So it's not everything on the market.
Yeah.
It is everything that is new and improved. So this year there were 13 that were available from the manufacturers. And because it ranged from like the, you know, Kia Sorento or the Toyota RAV4 all the way to a Range Rover Sport, we can't compare them to each other head-to-head. We compare them against our awards' six criteria, which include safety, value, efficiency, advancement in design, engineering excellence, and then one we call performance of intended function, which is basically how well the vehicle does its job.
Yeah.
And against all of these criteria, after we test all the cars, after we drive all the cars, we argue about these criteria, and we chose the Forester.
And how big was the argument with all the editors and experts at Motor Trend?
You know, it was pretty spirited. You know, we started with 13. We you know, kind of cut it in half, and that was pretty easy. And then going through, you know, like our finalists was not terribly difficult either until we got around to like the last three. And I would say really like, you know, the new Durango made a pretty strong case. It's got 8-speed transmission. It's like a more of the old school SUV in that it, you know, it can tow and it's got, you know, pretty good off-road and, you know, it's a fantastic three-row SUV. So that was probably in third place. And the really tough battle came down between the Grand Cherokee and the Forester. And, you know, the Jeep Grand Cherokee is an amazing vehicle. It comes with diesel, V8, a pretty good V6, and also the SRT version. And of course, they're super capable off-road and they look great and they're very handsome inside. But man, that Forester is amazing.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's also very affordable. I mean, it starts like a very low price and then it goes up a little bit, but then you still get a lot of car for the price, right?
Exactly. Yeah. The value is very high. I mean, you can get that vehicle. And again, value is relative. Like we appreciate that, you know, we picked the Mercedes-Benz GL last year and we got a lot of criticism for that car being, you know, you can get it into the 100,000s if you get the, you know, the GL 63. But relative to its class, you know, when you start talking about like a GL, you know, the Blue Tech, the diesel, it's like $65,000. That's pretty good for a luxury three-row SUV. Same thing for the Forester. I mean, you get this vehicle starting at $23,000 as the base model and nicely equipped, you know, in the $27,000-$28,000 range, and it's fully loaded at $33,000. And it's fast.
Yeah.
And it's fun. And it gets really good fuel economy. And it's the craziest thing, and this is where I think it really set itself apart, is that it looks, people give it a lot of, I think there's a lot of criticism about how it looks, but if you really appreciate car and vehicle engineering and product packaging, you look at that thing and you start scratching your head. You go, how do they do this?
Exactly.
The thing gets 8.7 inches of ground clearance. That is the same as like a rear, two-wheel drive FJ Cruiser, the same as a Ford Explorer. I mean, vehicles that you would think are like more capable off-road.
Yeah.
Yet, it's very spacious interior, very, very good visibility. That's the biggest thing. They're not doing the same thing everybody else is with the high belt lines. They've dropped the belt lines, so you have a great view of the road. You have a great view all around you.
Excellent.
And then,
Edward, I'm sorry. We're running out of time here in this segment, so I just wanted to let our audience know, motortrend.com for more information on how you did all the testing for this car, right?
Yep, absolutely. MotorTrend.com, and you can check us out on YouTube, too. There's a whole bunch of videos about it.
Excellent. And MotorTrend gives all their awards for other categories, right? So what's coming up?
We got Car of the Year coming up, and then we will do Truck of the Year soon after. So it's award season for us.
Excellent. Well, Edward Lowe, Editor-in-Chief at MotorTrend, thank you very much for your time again. I hope to talk to you soon.
Great. Thank you, Javier.
Thank you very much. Ya regresamos aquí en Auto 060. Yo soy Javier Mota.